Eileen Wilson and your host, Gordon McRae. Our choir is under the direction of Norman Luboff, and our music is arranged and conducted by Carmen Dragon. Yes, tonight another great musical success is brought to you by the American Railroad. The same railroads that also bring you most of the food you eat, the clothes you wear, the fuel you burn, and all the other things you use in your daily life. And now, here is Gordon McRae.
Thank you and good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, our show tonight is the work of two men who wrote such recent hits as Oklahoma, Carousel, and Allegro, Richard Rodgers and Oscar Hammerstein II. Yes, the Association of American Railroads brings you the 20th Century Fox Technicolor production, State Fair.
Our State Fair is a great State Fair. Don't miss it, don't even delay. It's dollars to donuts at our State Fair.
Appearing in our version of this award-winning motion picture is a young lady with whom I've had the pleasure of making many popular recordings, lovely Jo Stafford. Jo plays the part of the girl I fall in love with, while another lovely young lady, Miss Eileen Wilson, plays my sister. For myself, well, I play Wayne, a typical American boy on a typical American farm in Iowa. Hearts are light and hopes are high as we prepare for that great American institution, the State Fair.
It's a grand night for singing. The moon is riding high, and somewhere a bird is singing his heart at the sky. Oh,
hey, yes, perk up.
Oh, Wayne, go away and don't bother me.
Oh, come on, we're leaving for the State Fair tonight. This is no time to be loitering around in a porch swing moping.
I'm not moping.
Well, the least you could do is go in and help Mom with her mincemeat and pickles.
Pickles? I always thought State Fairs meant fun and romance. But all it means to this family is mincemeat, pickles, and hogs.
Hey, you better not let Dad hear you talking about Blue Boy as though we were an ordinary hog. Remember, we have a champion Hampshire boar in the family.
All right, so he's a boar. And so is this whole business. I only hope this year something different will happen, or I can meet someone new for a change.
Hey, this isn't like you, sis. Come on, tell me, what's the matter?
I don't know, Wayne. I'm as restless as a willow in a windstorm. I'm as jumpy as a puppet on a string. I'd say that I have spring fever, but I know it isn't spring. I'm starry-eyed and vaguely discontented, like a nightingale without a song to sing. Oh, why should I have spring fever when it isn't even spring? I keep wishing I was somewhere else, walking down a strange new street, hearing words that I have never heard from a man I've yet to be. I'm as dizzy as a spider spinning daydreams. I'm as giddy as a baby on a swing. I haven't seen a crocus or a rosebud or a robin on the wing. But I feel so gay in a melancholy way that it might as well be spring. It might as well be
free. Well, it sounds like you need sulfur and molasses, Margie. Come on now, snap out of it. Boy, what a fair this is going to be. I've planned everything Eleanor and I are going to do for the whole 3 days.
You can afford to be happy. Your girlfriend's going along.
Yeah. Too bad Harry can't make it.
Harry, that square. You know what he spent all last evening telling me about? The farm we're going to live on after I marry him, if I ever do. Everything modern, scientific irrigation, electric milking, no horses, just tractors.
Well, that's not the type of thing you want at all, is it, Sid?
You haven't heard the worst. He wants to tear down that sweet old farmhouse and put up a prefabricated one. Linoleum on every floor.
Oh, every room a bathroom, eh? That'll be just ducky for you, won't it?
In your air-conditioned patent leather farmhouse, on your ultra-modern scientific farm, you'll live in a streamlined heaven, and you'll waste no time on charm. No geraniums to clutter your veranda, nor a single little sentimental thing. No Virginia creeper, nothing useless.
Oh, Wayne, I'm so unhappy.
Telephone for you, Wayne. Cylinder. Sounds urgent.
Coming, Dad.
I'll be back in a minute, sir.
I keep wishing I were somewhere else, walking down a strange new street, hearing words that I have never heard from a man I'd yet to be. He would be a kind of handsome combination of Ronald Coleman, Charles Boyer, and Bing.
Margie, my dear little Margie, I make the world a ruby for your fingering and say, I love you, I love you, I love you.
What?
My darling, Margie, my chérie, you are beautiful.
And we feel so gay, in a melancholy way, that it might as well be spring. Boo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo.
Doggone it. Fine state fair this is gonna be.
Why, Wayne, what's the matter?
Oh, they had to call the doctor for Eleanor's mother last night. She can't go to the fair with us.
I'm sorry, Wayne.
Oh, children.
What is it, Mother?
Come along. We're off to the fair.
Anything I can do to help you, Mother?
Not a thing, dear. Thank you.
Anybody know where Dad went?
The moment we arrived, he went over to the swine pavilion with Blue Boy. That's probably where he'll be till it's time to leave.
Are you sure we can't help you with the trailer, Mom?
No, dear. You and Margie run down to the Midway and enjoy yourself. Just get back in time for dinner.
Okay. Come on, Margie.
Bye, Mom.
What'll we do next, Wayne? Want to ride the roller coaster?
No, I think I'll just walk around the Midway. You don't mind riding alone, do you?
Of course not. See you back at the trailer.
Okay.
Be sure to hang on with a dip.
Don't worry.
All right, folks. It's the biggest thrill on the Midway. A hair-raising ride on the Big Dipper. Only 10 cents, a tenth part of an hour. Here I go. Watch that happy group get the thrill of their ride. Up they go.
Oh, look at that dip.
Oh,
I'm sorry. That big dip frightened me.
Well, brace yourself. Here comes another.
Oh.
You know, if you're going to keep hugging me like this, the least I can do is introduce myself. I'm Pat Gilbert.
I'm Margie Frick, and I'm really not hugging you.
Well, of course, I could be wrong. Here's the tunnel. It's nearly over. Want to go around again?
No, thanks. I'd better not. Goodbye, and thank you.
Hey, Margie. Safer down here?
Oh, I thought you...
Changed my mind. When you walked away, I watched the way your hair bounced up and down. Kind of cute-like. And, well, here I am.
But I don't know you. And all you know about me is that my hair bounces when I walk. Everybody's hair bounces.
Mine doesn't. Suppose there's anything wrong in me walking you back to the campgrounds while we figure out if there's something we do have in common?
No, nothing wrong, but...
Then what are we waiting for? It ought to be fun finding out what we're like. Or it might be dull.
What do we do if it's dull?
Well, one of us just says, let's break it up. That's the end. No hard feelings. Agreed?
Agreed.
Here we go.
Well, let's find out about you first. What do you do? Work here at the fair?
Not exactly. I'm covering the fair for my newspaper, the Des Moines Register. Not the greatest job in the world right now, but my boss has promised me a chance to go to Chicago and do a column of my own when he thinks I'm ready. I'll be big time someday.
I'm sure you will. I guess I'd better go the rest of the way alone.
Yeah. I might be a little hard to explain to your folks. Well, shall I see you again? If you want to say...
Oh, no. I mean, do you?
Don't worry about me. Anytime I want to break it up, you'll know it. I just won't be there. See you tonight?
All right, unless my brother is lonesome and wants me to go with him.
Would you like another frozen custard, Emily?
Oh, no, thank you, Wayne. I have to go to work now. I sing with Tommy Thomas Stand over at the dance pavilion.
You're a singer?
I hope so. Well, that's nothing so awful, is it?
I look to you like a dumb country yokel who flirted with an actress.
Oh, you're wrong, Wayne. When you travel all the time and never see a familiar face, it gets very lonely. Before he spoke to me, I felt lost there on the Midway. Everyone was laughing and having such fun with their friends, but I was a stranger. And you said hello, and I had a friend, too.
Well, I watched you for a long while before I finally got the nerve to speak.
I know. I thought you'd never get the nerve. Just think, if your sweetheart back home had been able to come to the fair, we'd never have met.
Oh, Eleanor isn't really my girl. Just that we've been thrown together ever since we were kids. We just grew up together, that's all. It's nothing at all like...
Like what?
Well, like when... I saw you standing in the sun... And you were something to see. I know what I like, and I like what I saw, and I said to myself, that's for me. A lovely morning, I remarked,
and I was quick to agree.
Wanted to talk, and I nodded my head as I breathlessly said, for me.
I left you standing under stars, the day's adventures are through. There's nothing for me but the dream in my heart.
And the dream in my heart, that's for you.
Oh, my darling, that's for you.
I saw you standing in the sun, and you had something to see.
And I liked what I saw, and I said to myself, that's
a lovely morning, I remarked, and you were quick to agree.
You wanted to walk, and I nodded my head as I breathlessly said,
While we are listening to this pleasant story, second act of State Fair, starring Joe Stafford, Eileen Wilson, and your host, Gordon McRae.
Our State Fair is a great State Fair. Don't miss it, don't even delay.
Hi, sis. Have a good time this afternoon?
Wonderful. What about you?
Oh, it couldn't have been better. Swell fair this year, huh?
Yeah, swell. Here's the soap. You better wash. Dinner's almost ready.
Okay, thanks.
You going back to the Midway this evening?
Yep. I want to see a fella I met this afternoon. You don't mind?
Oh, no. I have a date, too, with a girl I met.
Oh, that's well. I saw you standing in the sun, and you were something to see. I know that I like what I saw, and I said the most
about that I have met. Well, you two sound as if you had a wonderful time this afternoon.
Hi, Mom. Well, we sure did.
Terrific. Oh, I wish your father was enjoying himself instead of brooding over that old pig.
Hey, something wrong with Blue Boy?
Oh, your father's worried because Blue Boy insists on lying down in his stall all the time. If you ask me, he's just exhausted from the trip.
I hope that's all it is. There'll be no living with Father if Blue Boy doesn't win the grand prize.
He'll be all right for the judging tomorrow. The thing I'm happiest about is the way you two perked up.
Well, I guess it's a fair, Mom. So many people laughing and enjoying themselves, it's only natural for some of it to rub off on Margie and me. Hey, now there's a guy with the right idea.
It's a grand night for singing. The moon is riding high, and somewhere a bird who is bound he'll be heard is throwing his heart at the sky. It's a grand night for singing. The stars are bright above. The earth is aglow, and to add to the show, I think I am falling in love.
Thank you.
made it, Ma. Sorry I'm late.
Well, Abel Frake, it's about time you forgot about hogs and paid a little attention to your wife. Kept your dinner warm as best I could.
Thanks, Melissa. Where are the kids?
Oh, they've gone to the Midway. How's Blue Boy?
Looking like the finest boar in the state. All that was wrong with that hog was that he was lonesome. Sort of spring feverish.
Now, Abel, I know you get to thinking of Blue Boy almost like a human being. But a hog with spring fever?
Well, it's true, Ma. He just lay there kind of drowsy-like till Hank Purdy brought in his prize sow, Esmeralda.
Oh.
And put her in the stall across from Blue Boy. Well, sir, she oinks at him and he oinks at her and starts strutting around that stall like the king of the fair.
Oh,
he'll win the grand prize, sure.
Oh, of course he will, Abel. Well, now help me carry my pickles and mincemeat over to the exhibition hall. Judging's first thing in the morning.
Sure a waste of time. Why don't those judges just come over here and hand you the blue ribbons? No one in the state can touch your pickles and mincemeat.
Oh, Abel. Oh, dear. Do you suppose I did right in letting the children go off to the Midway by themselves?
Oh, they can take care of themselves. I can see the two of them now, throwing darts of balloons, trying to win a Cupid doll.
How do you feel, Bobby Locke?
Scared? Of course not, Pat. Ferris wheels don't frighten me.
Look at all those ants down there. They think they're people.
Don't they look funny?
Yeah.
Pat, have you heard any more about that job in Chicago?
No, not yet, but I will any day now. Say, tomorrow's the last day of the fair. We'll see each other, won't we?
If you like, right after the judging. Unless you want to say, let's break it up.
Not on your life. I told you I just wouldn't be there if that happened. I'll meet you by the roller coaster, okay?
Okay. Where's the music coming from?
Dance pavilion. Not a bad orchestra. Cute singer, too. But not my type.
I'm glad. Oh.
What's the matter?
That looks like my brother standing there by the bandstand.
Well, you can't prove it by me. From this distance, one ant looks just like another.
This morning, fate gave me no warning. Great was my surprise. I saw you standing in the sun, and you were something to see. And I like what I saw, and I said to myself, that's for me. A lovely morning, I remarked, and you were quick to breathe. You wanted to walk, and I nodded my head as I breathlessly. Adventures are true. There's nothing for me but the dream in my heart and the dream in my heart that's for you. Oh, my darling,
I'm afraid this isn't much fun for you, hanging around waiting to catch me between songs.
Oh, I don't know if anything else I'd rather be doing. Anyway, can we go somewhere after the show, maybe have something to eat?
Oh, I can't tonight, Wayne. It's Marty's birthday.
Well, who's Marty?
Oh, one of the boys in the band. We're giving him a surprise party. Would you like to come?
Well, I was kind of counting on being alone with you.
I know. I'd like that better, too. But we cooked up this party a week ago, and it's going to be in my rooms at the hotel, and, well, I just can't back out now.
I guess not. I was counting us being alone tonight. There's something I wanted to tell you.
You sound awfully serious, Wayne.
Well, I am serious.
Well, don't frown like that. You look like you'd forgotten all the fun we've had together. I'm not a girl for sentimental tripe. I never go for the Romeo type.
Over a dewy-eyed Juliet, no one has seen me drool yet.
I don't say our hearts are tied by love's eternal tether,
but using words less dignified, isn't it kind of fun to be together?
Maybe you'll never be the love of my life. Maybe I'm not the girl of your dreams.
But isn't it kind of fun to look in each other's eyes, swapping romantic dreams?
Maybe I'm not a girl to have and to hold. Maybe you're not a boy who would stay.
But isn't it kind of fun carousing around the town, dancing the nights away? Isn't it kind of fun holding hands,
according to a sweet and corny custom?
Isn't it kind of fun making vows,
admitting that we both intend to bosom? Maybe we're out to laughs, a girl and a boy, getting across the table for two.
But haven't you got a hunch that this is the real McCoy, and all the things we tell each other are true? Isn't it kind of fun holding hands,
according to a sweet and corny custom? Isn't it kind of fun making vows,
admitting that we both intend to blossom? Oh, maybe we're out for laughs, the girl and the boy, getting across the table for two. But haven't you got a hunch that this is the real McCoy, and all the things we tell each other are true?
You have that hunch or not, but I certainly do.
Well, it's almost time for my next number. I have to go, really.
Can I see you tomorrow here?
If you like.
Oh, that's well. I'll be here right after the judging in the pavilion.
Quiet, quiet, please. May I have your attention? Now ready to announce the judge's decision and make the award.
And they hardly tasted my sour pickles. Those were mine, weren't they?
I'm trying to read the label. Mrs. Melissa Brake, they were yours, Mother.
Sour pickles. First prize, Mrs. Melissa Brake.
Oh.
You see, Mother, I told you your pickles were the best in the state. And did you see the looks on their faces when they tasted your mincemeat?
Quiet. Quiet, please. I have a special announcement. On rare occasions, the judges award a special plaque for distinguished achievement. Today, they voted this award to a lady who has concocted the most delicious, most succulent and tasty mincemeat ever entered in our state fair. Mrs. Melissa Frank.
Oh!
Mother, the plaque for distinguished achievement.
Oh, I hope they don't expect me to say anything. If they do, I know I'll cry.
Mother,
Attention, please. Hampshire Boars Grand Champion class are now about to be judged.
Look at Blue Boy, he's lying down.
He'll lose, sure.
Well, that's the way he acted before they put Esmeralda in the pen next to him.
Get up, Blue Boy.
Come on, Blue Boy, get up.
Look at your poor father.
Oh. The judges are disgusting.
Look, it's Esmeralda. Her class is just next, and she's at the gate of the hall.
Blue Boy's getting up. Look at your father, Bean.
Quiet. Attention, everyone. I have the honor to announce the winner of the Grand Championship. Number 1494, Blue Boy, owner Abel Gray.
Atta boy, Dad.
Blue Boy, the Grand Champion of Iowa.
Oh, I know all I owe, I owe, I owe. I owe, I owe all I owe, and I know why.
I am Iowa born and bred, and on Iowa corn I fed, not to mention her barley, wheat, and rye.
I owe Iowa for her ham, and her beef, and her lamb, and her strawberry jam, and her pie.
I owe Iowa more than I can ever pay, so I think I'll move to California.
Why shame, why shame? Good and gosh darn sorry when you go.
Don't I know?
When you leave your native
state,
you'll be feeling far from great. You'll be good and gosh darn sorry when you go.
I'm a seed of Iowa grain.
You're a breeze of Iowa blue.
I'm a drop of Iowa rain.
You're a drip of Iowa dew.
Oh, I know all I owe, I owe Iowa. I owe Iowa all I owe, and I know why.
I am Iowa born and bred, and on Iowa corn I'm fed, not to mention her barley, wheat, and rye.
I owe Iowa for her ham, and her beef, and her lamb, and her strawberry jam, and her pie.
Yo!
Though I'm owner more than I can ever pay, if to keep me on the cup, I'd like to stay. Better stay, better stay, better stay,
better stay.
If old Iowa is my home, I'm a fool who wander wrong. But there can't be any better home for me.
The fact which we mentioned a little while ago, that one person living on the farm of America today. Of State Fair, starring Joe Stafford, Eileen Wilson, and your host, Gordon McRae.
Our State Fair is a great State Fair. Don't miss it, don't even delay.
But Emily, all the things we said last night, was that just kidding?
Oh, no, Wayne, it wasn't kidding. But well, we were just two people who met at a fair.
We fell in love, didn't we?
Well, that's the part that I didn't bargain for.
Then why go to Chicago with the band tonight? Why can't you meet my father and mother and go home with us tomorrow?
Oh, Wayne, I can't. I should have told you before, but I was afraid to spoil something. It was just too sweet to spoil. Wayne, I have a husband.
You
split up a year ago. He never worked. Thought he was his generation's answer to Casanova. I've never looked at another man since. So knowing you made me believe that I had the right to a little happiness, too. Well, there's my number. Please wait for me, Wayne. I'll be right back after this song. Don't go away.
I saw you standing in the sun, and you
I know what I like, and I like what I saw, and I said to myself, you're a dumb country yokel who flirted with an actor.
Wait.
hi, sis. It's getting late. We'd better get back to the trailer. You've seen everything anyway, haven't you?
No, I've been waiting right here by the roller coaster all evening. I had an engagement, I thought.
Oh.
Don't worry about me, Bobby Lux. When I want to break it up, you'll know it. I just won't be there.
Oh, Wayne, take me home.
Melissa, did the kids seem kind of funny to you? I mean, since we got home from the fair, they act worried.
Oh, tired, perhaps, and let down after the excitement. Isn't that right, children?
What, Mother?
Well, I was telling your father I thought you were let down after the fair.
Yeah, you can say that again.
I never want to see another fair.
All you do is meet a lot of people who play you for a sucker and have some laughs at your expense. From now on, Brother, I'm staying here with my kind of people. I'll see you later.
Where are you off to, son?
Well, I thought I'd go see Eleanor. She called and said she was frying some chicken. I won't be home for dinner.
I thought he'd straighten out the minute he heard from Eleanor.
What about you, Margie? Didn't you have a good time at the fair, either?
Oh, there's the phone. You answer it, Margie. It's probably Harry, for you.
That's what I'm afraid of. Hello?
Hello, Margie. It's Pat.
Pat?
Yeah.
Oh, Pat. Pat, what happened? Why didn't you meet me?
I had to leave town.
Where?
Chicago.
Chicago? Did they give you your own column?
Yeah, came right out of the blue.
Oh, Pat, that's wonderful. How long do you have to stay in Chicago?
I'm not in Chicago.
You're not?
No, I'm right here in town.
You're in town?
Uh-huh. Can I come out to see you?
Oh, of course. Just drive out the North Road and keep going till you see me. And hurry, hurry.
I'm practically there.
I'll be right back, Mother, with a friend for dinner. Wayne? Wayne?
Hi. What's the matter, sis? You want a ride?
Please. Just part way into town. It's right on your way to Eleanor's.
Sure. Hop in. Well, here we go. You happy, sis?
It's a grand night for singing. The stars are bright above. The earth is aglowing.
Just a moment. Meanwhile, this is your host, Gordon McRae, giving a big vote of thanks to our excellent support.